What up, everybody? This is Charlie, and today I want to talk about vulnerability as a catalyst for moving movements forward. I recently watched a Brené Brown TED Talk on vulnerability, and her main premise is that vulnerability is an amazing and awesome strength that we can use to combat shame and to bring people closer together. Vulnerability is really like the key to social connection, and I'll actually link to the video below. It was actually really timely for me because in the last 2 weeks, I have been in a very low place. And usually when I'm in those low places, I tend to disengage from the movement. Like, kind of hibernate and go into self-care and, like, take bubble baths and watch videos and, like, do whatever I want to do. But in these 2 weeks, I couldn't do that. Like, I've been crazy busy with people reaching out to me to talk about race and gender and sexuality and disability stuff, and I've loved it. But like I said, I have not had any energy to do it, which completely changed what I was able to give. It sort of forced me into living what Brené Brown was talking about. Coming at these situations from a place of vulnerability. Within the social justice movements, we tend to prioritize anger over everything. That you've got the right to be mad, so you should be, this stuff is annoying, it shouldn't still be going on, and all of those things are completely true. But my anger in general tends to come out as tears. And so, I don't know what. So I don't really know why I thought that my approach to social justice movements would be any different. The cool thing, though, is that I have found that approach has actually been way more effective. It has had even better results than the full anger that I was trying to, like, conjure up within myself and, like, keep going to sustain me. And in reality, it's been way less toxic, too. Coming from a place of vulnerability has allowed me to empathize with people on all different sides of things. And I am not saying, like, I am not at all saying that empathy is the key answer, and if we just love out there, then that will make everything better. Because I don't think that love can dismantle systemic oppression. But I do think that love and vulnerability can change the hearts of people who can dismantle systemic oppression, and that is my real goal. And I am willing to do whatever it takes to get there. And if that means a little bit of vulnerability, so be it. So I would love to hear your thoughts on vulnerability as a catalyst for moving movements forward. If you have any experiences doing that or tips, I would love to start a conversation going in the comments. So, catch you around.